worship tonight. Hallelujah. Yeah, come on forward. Don't be afraid. Come forward. Don't be afraid. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we worship you tonight. Oh, we worship. Let's just begin to fix our eyes on Jesus tonight. Just begin to focus your eyes tonight. Oh, I was created to worship tonight. Just begin to stir up the well tonight. Just begin to stir up the well tonight. Just begin to stir up the well tonight. I was created. Yeah, yeah. Oh, we give you praise tonight. Shikirabasho. Oh, just begin to pull on heaven tonight. Kishatarabashondorabandariye. Kiyorabariyondo. Hey. Use your mouth tonight. Use your words tonight. Engage with heaven. We want to engage with heaven. We're after you. We're after you. Oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus. Oh, yeah, just keep pulling on heaven tonight. Open your mouth and let praise out tonight. Hey, Kirabashondo. It's at the sound of your praise. It's at the sound of your praise tonight. Shikira bariando. Oh, we stir up the wells tonight. Oh, we stir up the wells tonight. Oh, Karabashe, just begin to enter in tonight. Oh, Jesus, yeah. Oh, 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 hey, 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 yes, tonight. Oh, 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 yes, we're after you, we're after you. We want to give you all the praise tonight. Oh, we want to give you all the praise tonight. Jesus. And oh, Jesus, and oh, Jesus, and oh, and oh, and oh, ki arabashando, ki arabashando, ki arabashando, arabaka. Begin to engage with Jesus. Yeah. What about show? Yes, you are. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, oh, oh. And oh, 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 oh. Oh, 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 praise, we praise you, we praise you. And oh, 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 We're after Jesus. Oh, yeah. And oh, 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 no. Oh, 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 we're asking. We're asking tonight. And oh, 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 oh. Into a realm of praise tonight. Come on, come on, come on. There's none like Jesus. There's none like Jesus. Hey. Come on, come on tonight. Oh, oh, oh. Hey. Come and join in the song that the angels sing. Glory to our God in heaven's King. Come on, come and join in the song that the angels sing. Come and join, it's an invitation tonight that the angels sing. Come and join in the song that the angels sing. One more time tonight, come and join. That the angels sing. Glory to our God in heaven's King. Well, you're my name, Lord, I cry like a banner lifted high. For you are great, and you're great to be praised. And I will dance around your throne. Shout, I will shout tonight, and I will dance around your throne. In your presence is my home, and the rocks will not cry out. I will shout, yeah, and I will sing your praises. You are holy, you are holy, yeah, for you alone are worthy. Your angels sing. Glory to our God in heaven's King. Come and join in the song that your angels sing. Glory to our God in heaven. We'll tell them tonight, but your mighty name, Lord, I cry like a pen. Your throne in your presence is my. You're worthy of it all. You're worthy of it all. You're worthy of it all. Just sing it out tonight. You're worthy of it all. We came to give you praise. We've come to give you praise. You're worthy of it tonight, Jesus. You're worthy of it all. 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 Jesus, you're worthy of it all. You're worthy of it all. All right to you. Just tell them tonight one more time. You're worthy of it all. You're worthy of it all. You're worthy of it all. Worthy of it all, Jesus, and I will sing your praises. You are holy, yeah. For you alone, come on, glory, yeah. And I will sing your praises. Up tonight, raise your voice tonight, and you alone. We've come tonight to tell you, Jesus, you're worthy of it all. Oh, we've come to sing your praises. For you alone, worthy, worthy, Jesus. Let's hear your voices, and I will sing praises. Lift it up. You alone, oh, you're worthy, Jesus. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. And whatever it looks like, we're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. Just tell them tonight. We're after your heart. Whatever it looks like, come on, we're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. Whatever it looks like, tell them one more time. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. Whatever it looks like, I will sing your praises. And I will sing your praises. Raise your voice. You are holy, yeah. For you alone are worthy of the glory. One more time. And I will sing your praises. You are holy.
You are holy, yeah.
For you alone are worthy of the glory. One more time tonight. And I will sing your praises.
You are holy.
Oh yes you are, oh yes you are. You alone are worthy of the glory. I'm after your heart tonight. I'm after your heart tonight. I'm after your heart tonight. Whatever it looks like, come on. We're after your heart tonight. Can you tell them? We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. Whatever it looks like. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. Whatever it looks like, we're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. Whatever it looks like, raise your voice tonight. We're after your, tell them, We're after your heart tonight. Just you and Dad tonight.
We're after your heart tonight.
Oh, we're asking for greater levels. Oh, we're asking for greater levels. I'm after your heart tonight. Come on. Pull on heaven tonight. Pull on heaven tonight. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. We're after, come on tonight, Jesus. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. Oh, we're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. Whatever it looks like, we're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. We're after your heart tonight. Whatever it looks, oh, would you lift up a praise? Would you lift up a praise tonight? Oh, yes, we are. Hey, hey, hey. Jesus, 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 you welcome here tonight. Goodness flows, there is a fountain, and it drowns sorrows. There is an ocean, and it's deeper than fear. The tide is rising, rising. There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing from the heart of God. The flood of heaven crashing over us. The tide is rising. Let's sing that again tonight. There's a river. There is a river where goodness flows. There is a fountain and it drowns all flows. There is an ocean and it's deeper than fear. The tides rise. There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing from the heart of God. The flood of heaven crashing over us. The tides rise. Rise, 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 rise to Jesus, we come alive. Break open prison doors. And I believe tonight we can tap into a vein of worship. How many of you are in agreement with me right now? How many people believe that in worship we can tap into something where literally prison doors are broken open? That many of you are going to begin to feel you like you've been set free tonight. So I want you to begin to push in tonight. We're saying every captive gets set free tonight. In the presence of Jesus. Anything's possible. Do you believe that tonight? In the presence of Jesus, anything's possible. We're pulling on the faith. We're pulling on faith tonight to open every prison door. Come on, push in tonight. You have to want it tonight. Oh. Break open prison doors. Your captives free. Break open prison doors. Set all the captives free tonight. Break open prison doors. Set all your captives free. Would you declare tonight? Break open prison doors. Set every captive free. Come alive in the river. Just keep pushing in tonight. Oh, we're asking, break open prison doors, set all your captives free. Spring up a well, spring up a well, spring up a well in me. Nothing will stop my joy. I'm dancing in your streets. Spring up a well,
spring up a well, spring up a well in me.
Tonight. with showers. Oh, it's falling. Oh, it's falling. Oh, everyone's being touched tonight. Oh, there is freedom. One more time, I said freedom reigns in this place. Oh, it showers. Oh, it's falling. Oh, there is freedom. Oh, just push in tonight. He's after your heart tonight. Would you let him encounter you? Oh, it's falling tonight. And there is freedom. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, just tell him tonight, there is freedom. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. My freedom reigns in this place. Oh, lift it up tonight. With showers of mercy. Falling on every face, there is freedom. Oh, we'll lift it up one more time tonight. Sing, my freedom reigns in this place. And I will stay for a little while, until I look like the one I behold. And I will pour out my vial, until all of me is on the floor. And I will stay for a little while, until I look like the one I behold. And I will pour out my vial, until all of me is on the floor. And at your feet, oh, I will sing. And at your feet, oh, I will sing. Your name is sweet like honey. Your voice, it sounds like the waters. Your eyes are full of fire, fairer than the suns of men. Your name is pure and holy, and there is none found worthy. For there is none beside you, Lord of Lords and King of Kings. I give you all my worship. I give you all. Till I look like the one I behold. And I will pour out my vial until all of me is on the floor. Would you sing it again? And I will stay for a little while until I look like the one I behold. Oh, I will pour out my vial tonight until all of me is on the floor. And at your feet, oh, I will sing. Oh, at your feet, oh, I will. Oh, at your feet tonight. Oh, at your feet. Oh, I will sing. Oh, at your feet. Oh, I will sing. Your name is sweet like honey. Your voice, it sounds like the waters. Your eyes are full of fire, fairer than the sun. Your name is pure and holy, for you alone are worthy. There is not a sign to know the Lord to King of Kings. I give you all my worship. I give you all my worship. I give you all my worship. And for you alone are God. I give you all. The one I behold. I'll tell him tonight. And I will stay for a little while until I look like the one that I'm after. Oh, I will stay for a little while until I look like the one I behold. And I will pour out my vial until all of me is on the floor. 'Cause at your feet, oh, I will sing. At your feet, tell him tonight, at your feet, I will sing. At your feet, I will sing. Your name is pure and holy. Your voice sounds like the waters. Your eyes are full of fire. You're fairer than the sun's moon. Your name is pure and holy, and there is none found worthy, and there is none beside you, Lord, Lords and Kings. Your name is sweet like honey. Your voice sounds like the waters. Your eyes are full of fire. Your name is pure and holy, for you alone are worthy, and there is none beside you, Lord, the Lord is King. I give you all my worship. Give you all my worship. I give you all my worship. For you alone are God. Just begin to pour it out tonight. Oh, just begin to pour it out. Oh, just pour it out at the feet of Jesus. Oh, he's worthy, yes, he is. Give you all my worship. I give you all my worship. I give you all my worship. For you alone are God. I give you all my worship.
You are my praise.
For lift it up tonight. And I will give you all my worship. Every part, I give it all to Jesus. You alone,
I long to worship. You alone, I worship.
And I will give you all my, every part of who I am.
Lift up our hands to the heavens tonight. Let's worship Him tonight. Let's worship the King tonight. Let's glorify the Lord tonight. We worship You tonight, God. We worship You. We worship You tonight.
Oh, we want to make You. Oh, we sing holy. Oh, holy. Oh, holy.
Holy is the
Lord. Oh, holy.
Worship the King tonight.
Holy,
still holy, worthy is the Lord. Lift him up tonight. Lift him up tonight. Worship you. We worship you. We worship you. As you're watching us through live stream tonight, through Facebook Live, email us your prayer requests. We're going to be praying in just a moment. Your 911 prayer requests, your prayer requests tonight, prayer@theriverinyou.com. We want to pray for you tonight. We want to believe for a miracle with you. Whatever you're watching from tonight, whatever nation of the world, engage tonight. Engage, for the presence of God is in this place and coming through your TV screen tonight, coming through your computer tonight. Just engage with the presence. Engage with the presence. Email us tonight. We have several emails and we're going to be praying in just a moment, but we're going to give you a chance to go to your computer tonight and send your prayer request to prayer@theriverinyou.com, and we're going to pray for you tonight. We're going to pray for you and believe for a miracle. Come on, press in. Press in for the more tonight. There's on the bottom of your screen. You're going to email us tonight, and we're going to believe and declare for a miracle. We have some people that emailed us already. Their testimonies of words of knowledge were released, and they were in their living rooms or in their homes. They pressed in and believed for a miracle, and suddenly, something happened to their bodies, and they're pain free. We're just gonna read them in just a second. But as we worship Him tonight, we invite you to come and just email us tonight. Engage with the presence tonight. Engage with the presence. Show. Lift up your hands.
Oh, lift you up.
Engage with the presence tonight.
Oh, we lift you up.
Lift him up. Lift him up tonight.
Yes,
we lift you up, God. We lift you up. Come on, worship Him. Press in for the more. Press in for the more. Presence.
We gather tonight. This is a realm of your glory. This is a realm of your grace. I can feel your mighty power, and it's moving in this place. We're in the presence of angels with God's glory on their wings. Like the voice of many waters, I can hear the angels singing, holy, holy.
Tonight,
who needs to
receive
your glory?
increase.
Increase your glory on this.
For this is a season of acceleration in the presence. Season of acceleration. A season of acceleration. For there is acceleration in the heavenlies. There's a season that we step into. A season of acceleration. Dreams, vision, calling. Everything that has been in a holding pattern, suddenly, it's accelerating. Suddenly, things are falling into place. Suddenly, every trauma is coming into reality. Suddenly, everything that you've been believing, suddenly, everything that you've been hoping for, suddenly, is becoming a reality. It's becoming manifested in this physical realm. So tonight, receive your miracle. Every pressure of the past season, has been for a purpose. Has been for a purpose. Every obstacle, every mountain, every desert, every valley that you had to climb, it's been for a purpose. And tonight, He declares, He's declaring this suddenly, 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 every prison door was open. Suddenly, every prison door was open. Suddenly, in the midst of worship, in the midst of worship, in the midst of worship, in the midst of worshiping, suddenly, the prison doors were open. I don't know what your prison door looks like. I don't know what your cell looks like. I don't know what your dungeon looks like. I don't know what's surrounding you, in what place you've been confined into. I don't know what you've been through. I don't know what pressure men have put upon you. I don't know what chains have been surrounding you. I don't know what cell that you've been put into. I don't know what limitations, words, men have put upon you. But tonight is a night of freedom, of liberty. Tonight as we worship, every door is being opened. Every door is being opened. Every prison door is being opened. Children are coming home. The prodigals are coming home. The prodigals are coming home. You are stepping into your destiny. You're taking possession of what belongs to you. Yes. Yes. Miracles. Signs, wonders. The glory of the Lord. The prison doors are being opened. And you are free. Think a lap or two. You're free tonight. You're free tonight. Come on. Come on. Yeah. You are in the midst of worship. In the midst of prison. In the midst of stop of the glory. Every prison. Or two around this place. Yep. Suddenlies of heaven. Suddenly of heaven. Right in your room, home. Right in that room tonight. Light in that kitchen tonight. Heaven is coming down. Heaven is invading your cell tonight. Every prison bond is being opened. Every shackle is being loosened tonight. Lift up your hands. Every prison door, every shackle. Come against every word, every thought that says you're stuck. You're not stuck. You're not stuck. You're not stuck. No, you're not. You're being launched into your destiny. You're being launched into greater things. You're being launched into greater things tonight. It is yours. Do you want it? Do you want it? Take it. Come on, do you want it? Take it tonight. Take it by faith tonight. Take it by faith tonight. Oh, oh. You are holy.
You are holy. Holy.
Go to your computers, you're watching. To your email tonight. We want to hear what's happening in your home right now. We want to hear what's going on in that room. Come on, send us a testimony of what God is doing to you tonight, of what's happening right in that place. In the midst of the worship, there is freedom, there is liberty, manifestation of the power of God as we pursue His presence. As we pursue His presence, everything is found in His presence. Everything. Send us a testimony. Prayer at theriverinyou.com. Right at the bottom of your screen tonight. Send us your prayer requests right now. We're just going to pray for them in just a moment. Yeah. Jesus, we honor your presence in this place. It's you that we're after. It's you that we pursue. It's you that we're passionate about. It's you. It's you. You are our desire. We all gather that day. One accord, one spirit, one purpose to be filled. As long as it took, they pressed in. You're being filled tonight. Strength is being injected into you tonight. Healing is coming upon you tonight. Breakthrough, reshackle, lack is being removed. Come on, lack is lifting up. Whoa, lack is being lifted off of you tonight. He's filling you. He's filling. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Do we have any prayer requests right there, Bella? Bring those to me. We're going to pray right now. Just give me a couple of them right now.
We have a couple of 911s, Joe.
Couple 911s. Come on, lift up your hands. Don't unplug yourself from the presence. Come on, this is not a time to unplug, but a time to press in. If you press, this is a moment we go beyond. We're going to believe for a miracle tonight.
You were calling out for kidney failure yesterday. So Sophia,
speak louder.
Sophia is calling, emailing us for her mom, Alexandra. She's in the ER right now with kidney failure. She has disability and debilitating headaches, and she just needs prayer for this.
Come on, lift up your hands. Come on, lift up your hands tonight. Come on. It's not just a prayer to bless somebody. Jesus didn't just stretch his hands and just prayed. Hopefully, somehow, eventually, they would be healed. The Bible says that he was moved with compassion. Can we be moved with compassion tonight? Can we just be moved with compassion as we pray for Sophia tonight. In the ER with kidney failure. We just prayed not too long ago for a couple kids. One was 2 years old. That was in the ER. Kidney failure, tubes all around, couldn't breathe. The doctors didn't have much hope. We prayed that night. It came from a 911 call. And then the next day we received a testimony that he was being dismissed from the hospital and it was going home. We keep on saying this is bigger than Hamilton. This is bigger than this venue. This is bigger than this city. This is bigger than this region. We're touching nations. We're touching lives. We're creating an atmosphere for the Lord to touch lives across the world. The planet is being touched. Two of you are excited. Everybody else is like, whatever. Come on. He was moved with compassion. Jesus was moved with compassion. Could you stand with me? Come on, stand with me. Engage your faith with me. If you don't know what to pray, come on. Let the Spirit of God pray. Let the Spirit of God intercede. Lift up your voice. Let the Spirit of God intercede tonight. In Jesus' name, God, we thank you for the gift of healing tonight. We thank you, God, that the angels be dispatched tonight. Angels hearing healing. Angels, oh God, let your hand touch Sophia tonight in that hotel room, in that hospital room. In that hospital room tonight. Let your hands touch her, oh God. Let your breath. Come on, lift up your voice. Come on, lift up your voice. There is no spectators. This is not about a man or a woman. This is about us engaging with the presence of God. Come on, engaging our faith. Be moved with compassion. Jesus, have mercy. Jesus, have mercy tonight. We speak to your kidneys, Sophia. We speak life into your kidneys tonight. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. We speak healing. We speak the breath of God. Anybody with kidney problems right here in this room? Anybody with kidney problems? Quickly, quickly before we transition. Anybody with kidney problems? No? No? No kidney problems? No one? Everybody, their kidneys are good? No kidney stones or anything else? Nobody that you know that has kidney stones or kidney problems, kidney failure? Come on quickly. I want to pray for you right now. Don't wait. There's a 30, 40 second window. You've got to jump into it. Come on, right here on my left. Come up the stage. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Quickly, quickly. Somebody, we're going to pray for you right now. There's an anointing. Come on, kidney. Maybe if it's a sharp pain on your kidneys, whatever it is, we're going to pray for you right now. Come on, lift up your hands. Father, we declare a miracle tonight. A miracle tonight. A miracle tonight. A miracle tonight. Come on, engage with the presence. Come on, there's no spectators. We're not at a game. This is the presence of God in your room tonight. As you're watching us on live stream, Facebook Live, come on, engage with the presence of God tonight. Engage with the presence. Come on, engage tonight. Come on, engage tonight. Come on, what's going on with your kidneys? Show. Just ask her to just step back a tad.
I have two adult friends.
What's your name?
My name's Joan.
Joan, where are you from?
Toronto.
Toronto. You've been here several times, Joan.
Many times.
Why you just keep on coming back?
Are you kidding? No. God's
that was
here.
Just a question.
Come I can't on, get enough.
Whoa.
It's life changing.
It's life changing. Have you been, has God touched your life since you've been coming to the meetings?
Yes.
In what way? Tell us. Someone is getting drunk.
He just is filling my spirit.
Come
and
on.
he's empowering me. He's breaking me out of mindsets.
Come on.
Yeah.
in the last almost 3 months of pressing in for the more.
Yeah, and I'm a revivalist at heart. Yeah. I've just been crying out for this in my own spirit. So
he's doing
just,
a new thing.
I just love to see it
he's
happening.
He's doing a new thing.
Yeah.
I was, Prophet Darren and I today, we put out a Facebook Live and we were talking about it. And I was saying, you know what, we've been crying for revival. The church has been crying for revival. But until I am revived, I can never see revival.
Yeah, that's right.
We need to be awakened. Yeah. We need to be awakened. We need to be awakened. We need to be revived from our complacency. Come on.
Yeah.
We need to come alive.
Yeah.
We need to take over.
Yeah.
It's time.
Yeah.
It's time. So tell me what's going on. It's not your kidneys, but somebody that you know.
I have two friends on dialysis.
Come on.
Yeah, two.
Two.
They don't know each other, but I just have my girlfriend's husband and a woman.
Are you
going to
see them in the next 24 hours, 48 hours?
And my grandson.
You're going to see them?
I'm going to see the woman. I won't see the man or my grandson because they live far.
They live far?
Yeah.
Well, we're going to anoint a cloth or something.
Okay.
And you're going to send it to them.
Yep.
Is that all right?
Yeah, I would
and
love that.
We're going to anoint your hands, and you're going to see, you said, your friend?
Yeah, tomorrow
Come
night.
On. The Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Yeah, come on.
We're all been called to see miracles, signs, wonders.
Yeah.
This is not a movement about a person. This is a movement about the church arising to its full potential. What we've been called for. We all been called to pray for the sick, see the blind, see the lame walk. Come on. We all been called. Come on. Did Belle anoint you at your hands?
Yeah.
Come on, give her the mic.
One hand.
Show. Father, in Jesus' name. There's more. We declare in Jesus' name. Show. Healing power. Flow. Come on. Healing power. Flow. Come on. Come on. What's your name? Mary, where are you from?
Burlington,
just down the road. Is this your first time?
Yes.
Who else is here for the first time? Well, quite a few of you for the first time. Where you been in the last 70 days? On holidays? Have you been on holidays? How did you hear about the meetings?
Well, we actually went somewhere else to another venue.
You went to
something?
Another venue?
For something.
For something
and,
else?
And for a play, and we didn't like what was going on, so we left, and my friend told me about this, and I said, well, let's
So you
here.
Were at another venue.
Yes.
You didn't really like it, and your friend told him, let's go to the Glory Awakening Hamilton.
Yes.
And here you are.
Yes.
Well, you know what? What are you feeling tonight?
I feel like I'm coming back.
Can you hear what you say?
I feel like I'm coming back.
You're coming back to where?
Yes, to where I've met to
where you belong.
Yes.
The presence. Come on. Come on. Lift up your hands. Something going on with your kidneys?
I don't want to go into it in
Can
detail
Can we put
here,
this mic a little louder?
I don't want to go into it in detail
That's
here,
fine.
But I am, it is my kidneys.
Okay, let's just lift up your hands. That's all we need to know. Come on, church. Come on, who's got faith tonight? Help us. Come on, help us tonight. Let's engage together. Oh. Can Bella put her hand on your kidneys? Come on. Father, Jesus. Whoa. Do you feel that? Kojo? Kojo is being blasted back there behind you. Jesus, we thank you. Suddenly, Sarah is being blasted on my left side. Jesus, we thank you that you are the healer. We thank you. Father, we thank you tonight for your gift of life. Jesus, we thank you that you took all our infirmities, including the kidneys, including everything. So God, tonight, we simply thank you, Jesus, for the gift. For the gift. 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 The gift tonight. Release it, oh God. We receive it. Come on, say, I receive it. In Jesus' name, I receive my healing. Wow, Holy Spirit, come. Power, Jesus' name. Release it, Jesus' name. Shoo. Somebody needs to take a drink out there.
Take a drink.
Did you have pain on your kidneys or anything? Did you have pain or anything?
No, I have a chronic condition.
Yes. Father, yes. We thank you that it's over. It's done. Come on, somebody give him a clap offering tonight. It's done. It's over. Yeah, come on. Glory to God. Come on. You're going to go back and you're going to lay hands on somebody. And everyone that you see in front of you. Come on. Ben Johnson is in the house tonight. We love this man. Of course, Prophet Darren Kenny is going to come in just a second. But something happened to you. Come on, get on that mic. Something happened to you a few weeks ago when you came to the meeting. You were telling me today that Todd prayed for you, and what happened? Tell us.
Well, it was back in the church.
In the church.
And they were handing out prayer cloths that were anointed by Todd in Fresh Fire. And I noticed that afterwards, I went on to minister in the region that weekend, and my left hand started to burn, like, a lot. And so I tested it out, so I ordered, like, an iced cappuccino and was holding it in my hand. And my hand was still hot, really, really hot.
Today. We drove into this plaza. We were waiting for somebody. The heavens suddenly started being manifested over us, Darren, today. And it was pouring. Since this man arrived in this city, it's been pouring. Everywhere he goes, I remember when I was talking to him one time, and he said, "Hey, Joe, would you, you know, I even said, I'm going to carry your suitcase to, I think I said that, to San Antonio, Texas." He called me up, he said, "I'm going to San Antonio." And I said, "Darren, I need to go to San Antonio with you. I'm going to carry your suitcase, man." So I bought a ticket and I went with him. Well, what happened was, we were in two different flights because you left out of Ottawa. And as soon as I was landing in San Antonio, I saw this massive black cloud scrolling in. And the rains came down to the point that your plane was diverted somewhere else. Austin, right? It was delayed for hours. You got to get a bus to come all the way into San Antonio. And everywhere he goes, it rains, it pours. So there's something significant about the rains the last few days. Because I don't know about you, but if you're from the area, you know that we've been having an unusual summer. You know, droughts. We haven't seen rain for months. This is not normal. But suddenly, sorry, man. And then what happened? We drove into the plaza.
We drove into the plaza and then we went to Starbucks. And while I was in Starbucks, my hand got really, really hot. And so I had a word of knowledge for the barista behind the counter. And I just said, "I just sense you're under a tremendous amount of stress. And I see pressure and I see that eyes have been looking at you." And then her eyes started to well up. And so I asked, "What's going on?" She said, "I just had a miscarriage this past week. And I've been under a tremendous amount of pressure." And so I said, "Can I pray for you?" And I just released the peace of God into her. And it seems as though when I get a word of knowledge, my hand gets hot. So that's pretty cool.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
Actually, I was telling him, and I told some of you this past Tuesday, I woke up, and I haven't really watched the news. We've been just a little busy the last 3 months almost. And we haven't really had time to watch anything. One of the things that Bella and I love to watch is The Amazing Race. And The Amazing Race Canada been on, and we haven't had the time even to watch it. So don't tell me if who won or anything, because it's taped. We're going to watch it sometime. But what happens, I woke up on Tuesday and I told Bella, can you turn on the TV in the bedroom? Because I want to see if there's still people out there in our city. What's going on? If there's still going, what's happening? So she turned on the TV and I laid my head back onto the pillow and almost like onto your shoulder. And suddenly I closed my eyes for a second and I went into a vision. And the vision was, I saw the hand of God come and touched my right hand, the side of my right hand right here. And when it touched my right hand, I was electrocuted. It was like a lightning bolt touched me. And this jolt, I jumped up in bed and I had my eyes closed. And Bella said, what happened to you? And I said, the hand of God just touched me and electrocuted my right hand. So there's something about the hand. And we saw some healings going on Tuesday, and we pray for some people. Someone give God a clap tonight. Come on, can we just thank the worship team and Sarah and the worship team and Ben and everyone else? Wasn't that so amazing, taking us into the holy place? Something happens when we tap into the presence of God. Amen. So what's going on?
My mother's in the ER.
She's in the ER.
She went from her dialysis right into the ER. She's just not doing well.
Come on, lift up your hands tonight. We're going to anoint your hands. Come on.
Alexandra,
come on. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for your healing power, God. Show, Holy Spirit, come. In Jesus' name. Alexandra, we speak over your kidneys tonight. We declare the healing power of God right now to flow through your body. Touch your kidneys now in Jesus' name. Come on, give God a clap tonight. There's a few, another 911. Did we pray for this one? Sharon, what's going on here?
She needs favor with the court so she can receive custody of her 7 and 8 year old
Father,
grandchildren.
Father, in Jesus' name.
They're going to court next week.
We declare the favor of God over your lives. May the will of God be done in Jesus' mighty name. People are watching us. Come on. Can you stretch your hands to that camera right in the back and say, welcome the nations tonight. We welcome you from every nation that is watching. We welcome the ones that are going back to the archives and watching. So many people. We've got testimonies of people that go back into the archives and they receive, they hear the words of knowledge that were spoken days prior or whatever weeks, and they receive it, and they and suddenly where's that testimony? This one right here?
No, it's right here. You didn't see the testimony yet.
I heard the testimony earlier. I heard a little bit of the testimony.
This is amazing because on Wednesday, it's a good thing that you're talking about people watching the archives. On Wednesday, you had a word of knowledge for people that had broken bone that did not heal correctly.
Darren, You prophesied this over me a couple years ago. You prophesied that this man prophesied. He was with me in my church, and he said, Joe, you're going to meet the prime minister sometime. You prophesied that over me. Within, was it a week or two?
Yes.
I got an email asking if we would be open to be part of a private function with the prime minister. I'm telling you, he's going to prophesy over you tonight. I hope, I believe, I think.
I think he did yesterday.
Last night he did. He will. And they were going to send us another email it was going to be a private location. And within weeks, couple weeks, we were in the front row hearing Prime Minister Stephen Harper speaking here in Hamilton. I was in the front row with Bella, and maybe 10 feet in front of me was Stephen Harper speaking. He prophesied that, and then suddenly, it wasn't just in the meeting. He said, you are going to meet him. Then the meeting finished, and they said, well, the prime minister is going to take pictures with some people. Well, you know the crowd. Suddenly, everybody rushed up, and we were like, on a good day, I'm 5'5 on a very good day. And let me tell you one thing, today is a very good day. And everybody seemed to be taller than me that day. And because I'm 5'5, Bella's, you know, a good day, 5'3-ish. And today she's a little taller because she's got some stilettos on. I'm the one to blame for her stilettos because do you know, I went to Bulgaria and I brought home a suitcase full of shoes for my wife.
That's a very good husband.
I'm not kidding you. I brought her 10 pairs of shoes. I know exactly her size. I'm not going to tell you that story because there people are watching and they don't know who I am. But when the cameras are off, I'm going to tell you a story about those shoes. But anyways, so suddenly the crowd went in, and then we thought, oh my gosh, how are we going to get to the front of the line? And someone grabbed our hands and took us right to the front of the line. We were next in line to take the picture. He turned to us. Darren, I don't know, this was 2 years ago. This was 2 years ago. He turned to us and he said, so who are these lovely people? And I said, well, my name is Joe Bella Garcia. We are the pastors at the River Church here in Hamilton. He goes, great. Let's turn to the camera and take a picture. Let's smile. So we turned around, we smiled. And I thought that was that. Then he turned around and he said, well, Joe Bella, I want to bless you today. I want to bless you. I want to bless your lives. I want to bless your ministry. And I'm like, what in the world? Can I pinch myself right now? The top leader of our nation blessed us individually, blessed our ministry that day. And then I think suddenly, within two or three more people, they closed the line. And then a few other people couldn't get the picture taken. You prophesy that. You prophesy. Why did I say that?
Broken bones.
Broken bones. So you prophesy the broken bone. Behind a great man, there's a greater woman. Believe you me. You think you're great, man? Think again. She's greater than you. That's all I'm saying. You know what? She's the smart one in the marriage. Just telling you. She's smart. She loves math. Everyone that loves math is smart. In my book. So you prophesied broken bones. He says there's a healing mantle that is coming upon you that, you know, God is going to use you to heal broken bones. Within a week, we were in that church, in our church, and I had a word of knowledge for a broken bone. And suddenly someone comes from the back, a man that was visiting that morning. His toe was broken. I prayed for him. And suddenly, he started running around the church and his toe was completely healed. So Wednesday, the Lord told me that he was going to heal broken bones.
Yes, so you had that word of knowledge and Carl knew that.
Isn't she beautiful, my wife? Come on, tell me something. Tell me something. Tell me something. The honesty. Everybody watching online, aren't we cute? I'm just telling you. Do you know that was 26 years of marriage on the 21st of July? 26 years of marriage. Last year was our 25th wedding anniversary. We just celebrated 20. I know I'm not a day older than 27, but we've been married for 26 years. We have three kids. Our baby girl is in the front row, Rachel, 13. Our middle son, Joel, playing the drums night after night. God's touched his life the last 70 days. And when he came to me and he said, Dad, I don't want to be making pizzas anymore. I want to serve God full time. He quit his job to serve the Lord full time, night after night after night. He says, I've never been addicted to anything, but I hear people talking about addictions. He says, something comes over me. There's this addiction. There's this something. Joel, right? Something comes over, come on here, Joel. Something comes over me when I play the drums. And I feel this thing that comes, it's called the Holy Spirit, the presence of God. Something is happening, even with our children, even with the young generation. Come on, you have 30 seconds to tell us what's going on. Isn't he cute? Doesn't he take after his dad? We have a firstborn named Andy or Andrew Garcia. He's camping this weekend. And yeah, he's a photocopy of that. But Joel, man, you're the man. Tell us.
It was going to happen. Yeah, like I've never been like addicted. Okay, I've been addicted to video games, but that's about it.
honesty above all.
Honesty comes out. Yeah, but there's like when you're playing the song and then you feel it and it's like it's not like it's not heavy. It's like it's thick and it's beautiful and it's like. It's thick, but it makes you feel so light and makes you feel like, you know, you can do whatever you want.
That's right.
Right? You feel it heavy, but it makes you feel like light and it's like, wow. 30 seconds.
So let's look at that camera, son, right there behind there. Yeah. And let's just, maybe someone is battling an addiction today. And maybe you've been battling addiction. Maybe Joel is 19. Doesn't look a day older than 12, right? Just, he has his dad's genes.
Not literally.
You are my
dad. We swap pens every so often. So maybe someone is battling an addiction. You know what? If whatever you're going through tonight, let's just declare that the Lord Jesus, his presence, mm-hmm. will invade their hearts, their minds, their homes, their place where they live, yeah. that their hearts would be filled with the presence of God, that the Holy Spirit would grab a hold of you tonight, that He will become your addiction, mm-hmm. that His presence will become your addiction. You know, we were created with a void. You were created with a void. We're all created with a void. And sometimes we try to fill it with stuff, but only Jesus can fit that void, His presence. So, we love you, man. You're awesome. Anyways, back to the pain.
So back to this praise report.
Yeah.
So you had that word of knowledge, and Carl knew that this was his sister had a problem with that. She had many other problems. So he sent in a prayer request. We prayed for her.
On that night, I had a word of knowledge. Carl?
Yes.
Carl sent the prayer request for his sister. That was not even with him.
Yeah, she was
the
in
The sister
rehab.
Was in a rehab somewhere else.
Yes.
Okay.
And he called her, and the pain that she had went away immediately.
This is why it's so important when you watch, not only to stand for yourself or for someone else. When the presence of God is released, when the word of knowledge is released, you send us those requests right away.
So the pain that she had went away immediately, but she still had other problems. So he told her to watch the replay.
Okay. So he's talked to her. And then he said, well, you know what? You got other problems. So go back and watch the replay of that night. Go back and re-watch that broadcast. TheRiverChurch.ca. You can go back and there's the archives button. And you can watch all the replays. All the way back to God knows what.
From the beginning. May 27th.
Yep.
So this is, she actually sent us a copy of the text that she sent to him. She said, I got it. So beautiful. Receive these words and love of our Jesus, of our Lord, dear Jesus. Pain gone in leg. I've had it since I started walking. That's how long she's had pain. Since a baby.
Felt warm shift.
She felt arm shift back
into place. An arm. Sorry, yeah. Not warm.
She felt the arm, her arm shift back into place. That was amazing. Had quite a large dent below shoulder. It's no longer there. No more metal jutting out.
So hold on. It seems that she had a metal in her shoulder, and suddenly it was just, it disappeared. Suddenly the metal on her shoulder disappeared. She says, no longer there. Dent below shoulder. It's no longer there. No more metal juggling out of my shoulder. So now tell me more.
The arms feel tight and stable. Our God is great and has infinite love. I feel His love in me. I keep feeling
all about a word of knowledge. Someone told somebody else, and someone said, you've got more stuff going on in your body. Go back, watch the replay, and see what God is going to do. Come on. Somebody needs to get excited. Give Him a shout of praise tonight. Glory to God. We have a few more. A prayer request right here. We're going to pray for them right now. In Jesus' name.
Pretty much all of them for financial breakthrough.
Financial breakthrough for Joanne, Jacqueline, Violet.
Belleen.
Terry. If you're watching us, Who else?
Jacqueline.
Somebody else? Terry. You're watching David. And Evangelist Wadibis, I think it is. If you're watching us and you're praying for, you're believing for a financial miracle. This is the year of Jubilee.
Come on.
This is the year of Jubilee. Not only, Darren was not talking about last night, not only debt is going to be canceled, but even mortgages are going to be canceled. Come on, stand to your feet. Let's believe for a miracle tonight. Father, we thank you for financial breakthrough tonight. Not only over these people, but over our lives in this room. Through live stream, to whatever you're watching from, we declare the breaking of Lord, we declare a breakthrough, a breaker anointing that would be released. This is the year of Jubilee. We thank you for death paid off, increase of finances, the suddenlies of heaven, the more of God. Let it be released. For you take pleasure in our prosperity that includes our bank account, our wallets, oh God. For kingdom advance, I declare in Jesus' name, somebody put your hands together and give him a clap offering tonight in a shout of praise. Come on, shout of praise. Come on, a shout of praise. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yeah. Yeah. Coming up in just 2 weeks from this weekend, Heaven Invading Earth Conference. Todd will be back for that weekend. As you know, Todd has transitioned to other things, is calling across Canada. And if you're watching, he's going to be in Onion Lake this coming weekend, ministering to the First Nations in Onion Lake. We love Todd and Jessa. And he's going to be with us here on August 25th, 27th, 28th, 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th. Todd is going to be with us. Charlie Champ. How many people know Charlie Champ or have heard of Charlie Champ? Great man of God. Young man of God, but on fire. Miracles, signs, wonders, gold teeth falling, teeth, all of this stuff. Amazing miracles in his meetings. You want to bring the sick that weekend. We're going to continue to press on next week and the week after that. Tuesday to Sunday, we'll be here 7 p.m. And we're going to continue to believe. We're going to continue to press in. This is unstoppable glory. Unstoppable glory. We're not stopping. We're not stopping. We're not stopping. I'm not stopping. I'm not stopping. I'm not stopping. Every word and everybody that thought I was going to stop, we're not stopping. We're pressing in. We're pressing in. The well is being dug deeper. We're not only redigging, but digging new wells. We're not stopping. We're moving forward. And on the 28th will be a last day here at the building. We took over this building for the summer, and we're going to be transitioning to our original location at the river at 1221 Wilson Street. Is there at the Ancastra Hill, bottom of the Ancastra Hill. And we're going to take a week and a half off to transition onto our building. And starting on the 8th of September, everybody say 8th of September. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, 7 p.m. Our meetings are going to go from Thursday to Sunday night, 7 p.m., 8th of September. Continue on. We're going to pause for a week and a half to transition. Actually, during that time, Bella and I will be in the Carolinas caring and pressing in with Todd and Jessa for the Carolinas Awakening and American Awakening. We're going to be with them. We're going to press on. But on the 8th, we're going to go back to our Thursday to Sunday night at the River Church location in West Hamilton, bottom of the Ancaster Hill. And we are not stopping, because there is greater glory. There's greater glory. There's a deeper level that he's taking us into. And this is the hour to press in for the more. Why not here? Why not now? Amen. Do we have somebody on
yes,
the line?
Yes, Joe, we have. Yesterday you had a word of knowledge for hips. We have Faye on the line.
Faye, where is Faye from?
My sister, Faye, F-A-Y-E. Yeah. She has both hips, or bone on bone. She's in a lot of pain, and she's got surgery Monday.
Is she in the area?
She's in Mississauga.
Mississauga.
But she just moved today, too, so a lot, nothing's all up. I still believe God can heal her.
Hey, Faye, how are you? Hi, Faye. This is Pastor Joe. How are you?
Pardon?
This is Pastor Joe. How are you?
I'm pretty uncomfortable.
Uncomfortable. Do you have...
Monday for a hip replacement.
So do you have pain on your hips right now?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to pray for you right now. Is that okay?
Okay.
Do you believe that Jesus can heal you tonight?
Yeah.
Okay. There's several people in this room and thousands watching on live stream around the world, and we're going to believe with you. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Come on. And above all, Jesus is going to release his power and touch you tonight. Amen? Come on, let's stretch our hands to Faith tonight. Father, I pray for Faith tonight. I declare your healing power to flow through her body tonight. In Jesus' mighty name, we declare a creative miracle over your hips tonight. We thank you. We thank you tonight for a creative miracle, oh God. We speak healing. We declare pain to be gone. Pain gone. In Jesus' name, I declare the virtue of God to come upon you tonight. In Jesus' name, show. I declare the fire of God to touch your body right now. In Jesus' name, we command pain, go. We command pain, go. Now, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus. Faye, are you there?
Yeah.
Do you feel anything happening to your body right now?
No.
Nothing is happening?
No.
Did you feel God touch you or anything?
No.
You feel faith rising or anything? No. That's okay. Because we have faith. Oh, come on. We have lots of faith over here. Yep. Yep. Is the pain the same, or did you feel a difference in the pain?
The same.
The same? Okay. Are you standing or you're sitting down?
Sitting.
You're sitting. Could you stand? Is that okay if you stand? I'm going to ask you to test it out. Is that okay?
Okay.
All right. Can you just engage in the presence of God with us tonight? Come on.
Okay.
Is that all right? Can you put your faith at work with us? Come on, let's just call on heaven tonight. Come on, church, let's lift up our faith. Come on, everybody watching on live stream tonight. Come on, let's lift up our faith. Let our voices to the heavens. Let's engage our faith tonight. Come on, faith. If you can walk in your room, would you do that as we pray? Yeah? Is that okay? Okay, Shikarababa, in Jesus' name we thank you, God. We declare healing power to flow right now. We declare healing power to, we command your hips to be healed right now. In Jesus' name, I command your hips to be healed right now. I command the pain to be lifted from your hips right now. I come against the spirit of infirmity over your body. In Jesus' name, show. Come on, give him a clap offering in this place. Yes, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Faye, how do you feel?
I believe in the healing power.
You believe it? That's great. That's awesome. Any difference in the pain?
No?
Okay, we're just going to believe that it will be a progressive healing, and you're going to receive it. Amen? I'm going to pass the phone back to your sister.
Thank you very
much. And we bless you tonight, okay?
Thank you.
We bless you. We bless you tonight. Be blessed. Come on, glory to God. Give God a clap tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Woo. I was painting, and there's some glitter going on. So I don't know what that is, but probably is glitter. So we'll just say it's glitter, all right? Can you stand up with me tonight for a sec? Yay, God. Lift up your hands to the heavens. Jesus, we thank you for your presence. Wow. We thank you for your presence in this place. We welcome your presence. We thank you for your presence. There's nothing else that we would want, but your presence, just your presence, God. So tonight we give you permission to do whatever you want to do. Have your way, Jesus. Touch those who are watching. Speak to us tonight, God. We pray in Jesus' name. Can we put our hands together and welcome Prophet Darren Kenny, my very good friend, to the stage, to Glory Awakening Hamilton. I love this man. Love this man. He goes around the world. He just came back from Australia. You know, 2 months in Australia, preaching, pressing on. Man, we just, you know, it's been almost a year since he's been with us. And we love you, man. We do love you. And, you know, we were just talking about tonight that 2.5 years ago, Darren had this burden for Hamilton, for this region. And he felt that he needed to come. And I think it was our buddy back there. Yeah, he's looking back. Scott, that connected you with Jiva in the area. And then we came together, and together we hosted the Heaven Invading Earth Conference with Jiva Sam from the Niagara region. Some of you know Joshua Mills. You know, it was his father, Ron Mills, which he is a great friend of ours. And we came together, and there was not too many people in the room, Darren.
No, there wasn't.
But the Holy Spirit was present. And we pressed in, and God still keeps on saying, do not despise the small beginnings. So, Darren, we honor you, man. We love you. And we're just so blessed that you're here with us, pressing in, digging, and redigging the wells.
Amen.
Come on. Come on. Put your hands together. Give him a clap offering tonight. Yay, God.
Well, I'm really glad to be here tonight. I just feel more liberty in the atmosphere even this evening. Whew. Amen. Some of you, listen, one of the words that I had, and I want to release this quick. First, I want to say hello to Sue Kopchick, who's right here. She's actually the first person who had me in this region to preach. And that was probably 5 years ago. I believe it was quite a while. And it was down in Brantford. And we had some, I mean, some of you were in those meetings. We had some wild times back then. I remember filling that room right up and seeing people touched by the power of God. I have always had a lot of favor in this region, but it was because of those meetings and Jamie Robertson, who was a mutual friend of ours, who set that up. And then Jiva and Scott came along, and then it grew, and we did so much. I think now we've ministered to really, I wouldn't know how many, but this hundreds and maybe thousands at this point in this region, amen? And God is growing this thing. It's not the end of it, but it's just the beginning and a new day. It's a new time. It's a new season. And I keep sensing that you, there's people in this room that God is about to change things for you and stretch things. You're about to be stretched in a new way. And I'm gonna release some words here tonight. But one of the things that I'm sensing is somebody out there, maybe in this room, might be, it's probably someone online as well, you're struggling in the area of finances. And specifically, you have a fear you're about to lose something. Could be your house, could be your car, could be your marriage, because of the financial burden that's upon your life. I want you to know that that's a lie. That is actually a lie of the devil. I had to struggle through the fear of losing my house at one point in my life. And when it broke, I never worried about it again. Never had a problem with my mortgage again. It's a lie. So I just declare a breaking of the lies in the area of finances right now. Because blessing, finances are a blessing from God. And he wants to bless you. And I declare the blessing of God over that area of your life right now in Jesus' name. That you will be blessed, blessed, blessed. One of my main messages in my life is the blessing of God. I've experienced the blessing of God in incredible ways. The reason why I walk in the blessings I do is when I came to the Christ, which was only 12 years ago. I was an atheist before that for 9. Before that, I served the Lord, and I even went to Bible school, but I can't really say my faith was that strong. I always had fear. I didn't really have a complete faith that there was a God. But when I came back to the Lord, one of the challenges he did for me was to read the Bible through as fast as I could, and I read it through in 18 days. And I read it 8 to 12 hours a day during that time. And one of the things that stood out to me in the scripture was the blessing that there is in obedience to Christ and the curse that comes from disobedience. And because I had chosen the path of obedience, the Lord said to me, you're blessed, blessed, blessed. And if you want to know what the blessing is, it's Deuteronomy 28. Everything is blessed in your life. The fruit of the womb is blessed. You're blessed when you go in and come out. You're blessed in the country and in the city. Your house is blessed. Your property is blessed. Your cattle is blessed. Your jobs are blessed. You're the head and you're not the tail. Now, when that hit me, I knew that God said to me that my life will be completely blessed for the rest of my life. I was 32 years old when I heard that. I had a marriage that fell apart, which was just traumatizing. It was the reason why I tried to kill myself. 1 year after that occurred, I was trying to commit suicide, and I was an atheist. And in the middle of that attempt, God spoke to me and told me he had a plan for my life, but it took 2 more years. I was 30 when I tried to commit suicide, and I did it twice. But God saved me, and he told me he had a plan, but it took me 2 more years to find a church to actually enter into, to become discipled, to enter into that call. But when I heard the Lord say that my life was blessed, I had nothing, guys. Nothing. I'm telling you, I didn't even have a job then. I had $16,000 in debt. My children were far away from me. The Lord told me I would have a big family. And I knew it was true. And today, 12 years later, I've been around the world many times. We have a beautiful home. My wife, Lydia, and I, we have 5 children. I have a restored relationship with my 2 other daughters. God is bringing them to salvation. Are you hearing me? In my jobs that I had while I was in the world, I always had favor. They didn't always like me. Are you hearing me? Because I was wild, a wild Christian. I've always been a wild Christian. There's no other way to be. That's the truth. And I saw miracles, signs, and wonders break out in the government cubicles of Canada. I prayed for ministers in high places in the government of Canada, release prophetic words over them, and even had a minister in the government of Canada tell me that he used to read my prophetic words, and they meant a lot to him. Are you hearing me? That's blessed. And God is going to bless you. When my wife tapped into the fruit of the womb, was blessed. We had all of our kids, the 5 kids we have, were all born in 6 years. And she had no pain in childbirth. And messed the doctors right up. They didn't know what to do with her. They used to write notes in her file. This one is special. She has no pain. And I'm just being honest with you. We knew the blessing. She knew the blessing. And we entered into the blessing. And the blessing on my life, and the favor on my life, it just seems to increase. Are you hearing me? It's saying God, like he blessed me right from the beginning with a word saying that I would be blessed, and I'm seeing the manifestation of that blessing every single day since. You see, I always tell my church, I go to a little church that's had a big impact in the Ottawa Valley, Mark Redner, is my senior pastor. I've been there 12 years. And every year I would get up in front of the church and say, you think I'm blessed now? I said, wait till next year this time. I'm serious. You know, you think I'm blessed now? You wait till next year this time and see the blessing on my life then. And sure enough, next year there'd be another kid. I'd get a promotion. More money would be coming in. You know, whatever that blessing was. And then I'd stand up in front of them again. You see, you guys, I told you last year that I would be more blessed this year. But wait till next year. And then I went in front of them this year. I had come back from Australia, where we had spent 9 weeks. I preached in 20 churches in 6 states. I prophesied, it's the royal we, right? I prophesied over 1,200 to 1,400 people. We saw miracle signs and wonders break out in every place that we went to. We saw people delivered from the enemy, from the devil. I know, you know, a lot of churches, you're not allowed to say the devil anymore, but say, if you say the name, do you say the devil, it means you're afraid of him. No, he's just the devil. You hear me? And he gets pushed out real easy. You just got to take your authority up and stand in it. So we saw that happen. 9 weeks, came back. We made so much money, I hate to tell you guys that, that I paid off all my debt. And we needed a ministry vehicle because we traveled through the United States and was able to buy that. Right last week, we got a new ministry vehicle to drive through the U.S., mostly through the United States. My ministry is really big in the southern part of the U.S., in all the southern states. I don't know why. It just happened, okay? You don't know why, but you just go. It's better to go where you're favored than tolerate it. You know what I mean? So I've gone down there. I've had so many churches open up for me and my ministry. But we had this tiny caravan for 5 kids. And we used to, it was like, okay, Lydia, what are we taking? Okay, you can take the stroller or you can take the playpen, but you can't take both. You know what I mean? Like, and then last year, we went down, we did 2 trips in 1 year. I'm just telling you this so you understand the blessing, okay? So we went on a trip. My friend, Mennonite family, lent me their old van. It was 16 years old. He said, you know, there's some problems with this van. I said, I don't care. It's big, you know. It had 12 seats. We could put everything. We didn't have to negotiate. I didn't have to say, Lydia, what are you going to leave behind? We could take it all plus the kids. Right? I didn't have to leave any kids behind. Sometimes you'd like to, though. You know what I mean? So I'm going across the border into the United States. I think it was February. It might have been January. It was the coldest day of the winter. The van broke down within 2 hours of us taking it, and I had to spend $300 to get the starter replaced. And it just happened to break down in the town where I had really close friends living, and they were able to get me to the mechanic that wouldn't steal half my money, which wasn't very much because I only had really enough money to get to the first town. And if they didn't pay us, we wouldn't have got to the next. And that's the way I live my life. That's the way I live. I just go by faith, and I still do that. For you guys who've known me for a long time, you know that's the way I live. I still live that way. I just believe for a lot more now than I did 5 years ago or 7 years ago. But it's the same faith. Are you hearing me? So we get down there. The window won't open. Now, that caused me a little bit of tension. I had inner healing because the window would not open. I was trying to figure out how I'm going to talk to the toll booth and, you know, if I got to open the, I can't open the window, I got to open the door, and I got to talk to the customs people and explain to them what's going on. And I didn't like that, but I get to the southern part of the U.S., and all of a sudden, the door won't open and the window. Now I'm just going through, like, clear panic attacks. I'm like, it's a car, the same night the door broke, the light stopped working in the front of the car, and I had to drive 1 hour in the dark. So now not just panic attacks, I'm looking for a washroom. I'm like, what in the world, God? Like, you want? I always said to people, there's one way to increase your prayer life, and that's to drive 10,000 kilometers in an old van. You want to talk about, and I was one of the best things I ever did. Because every town I went into, and I probably ministered to 2,000 people in 5 weeks, every town I went into, the pastors would begin to pray for a new van for us. They're like, guys, you don't understand. These guys, they're lucky to be here. This van, like we gotta. Every town I went into, we had to have somebody fix something in that old van. And we had people declaring a brand new van. Well, within 6 months of that declaration, the van manifested. Are you hearing me? I mean, you gotta just trust the Lord. I tell people, you know, my ministry is it's really all by faith. Even now, it's all by faith. We don't have a big cozy bank account. I don't know what I would do with that. I probably would give it all away. I already, you know, I came back from Australia. I already sowed so much. My wife looks at me. I said, girl, don't worry about it. This is our sowing season. I'm telling you, like thousands of dollars sowing. A month ago, I gave one of my cars away. And when I gave it away, I said to the person, that's because we're going to have our debt canceled real quick. And it happened. You see, you gotta know something about God. You gotta know something about Him. He's more interested in taking care of you and blessing you than you are in receiving it. God is able to take care of you. The promise of God is that you don't have to worry about tomorrow. You don't have to worry. You don't have to worry about a day ever again when you get the revelation that God is your provider. He's able to take care of you. Now, I got a bit wild in the last few years. I decided that I'm not even just going to, if I don't have a financial need, I'm going to create them. I listened to Patricia King, and she was talking about that. She said, sometimes, you know, I got these real financial needs, And I got to extend myself and believe for a lot. But she says, sometimes it gets easy. So what I started to do was to actually believe for other people's finances and take them on. So she said she was talking to a guy one time from Africa who needed $60,000. And she just blurted out, I'll take care of that. He was like, thank you, Jesus. Right? And then she went back to her prayer team, and they said, you did what? You don't have that money. There's not a dime in the bank, right? She said, I guess we're just going to have to start praying. And I think she said within 1 week that money manifested, and it went to the guy. So I thought, if Patricia King can do it, then I'm going to do it. And I started taking on other people's. I'm not going to take yours on. You can keep your hand down. I'm not telling you, you know. You can take mine on if you like. Woo! About a year ago, I was leaving my cozy government job, making pretty good money. You know what I mean? I mean, it was a government. I was an economist. I was a senior economist. I was starting to move into the middle management range. And that's God said, when you begin to move into the middle management, that's when you're going to resign and go into full-time ministry. So that happened, and I left. But 2 months before I left, I was invited to preach a conference in Puerto Rico. And the guy who invited me, he said, I'm paying for everything. He said, I'm taking care of your flight. I said, praise God. Nobody ever takes care of my flight. I mean, honestly, I was like, thank you, Jesus. And he said, I'm going to put you in a nice place. I went, thank you, Lord. And then he said, I got four other people coming. I'm taking care of them too. I was like, praise, that's going to be a good conference. And then he started naming off some of the guys who were coming. And they were like the well-known preachers. I went, praise you, Lord. This is a good conference I'm getting invited to here. And then he goes, I have no idea how I'm going to pay for it, though. He said, but I'm doing it. God does it every year. And then he said it again. I have no idea how I'm going to pay for it. And God said, yeah, I do. He said, you're going to pay for it. I said, no, I'm not, God. God said, yeah, you're going to pay for that. I said, God, I'm leaving my job. You know what I mean? It was $4,000 I would have had to come up with. I said, God, I don't have $4,000. I don't even have, I have the month's salary for that time that, for that. And you want me to pay for it? He said, yes. And I said, I'll do it. And I blurted out, he's on the phone, I don't know how I'm going to pay for that. I said, I tell you what, I'm going to pay for it. And I went, oh, my God, I didn't even talk to Lydia about it. You know? Didn't even bring it up. I just said, we'll pay for it. He's like, what? I said, yeah, we'll pay for that. He said, okay, great. I went, oh, my Lord, now I'm in something. You know what I mean? And within 1 month, we had most of that paid off. And then when we got to the conference, we got a little bit, but within 1 month of that, we had a double portion. Are you hearing me? God began to show me he could take care of anything. And that if I would just stretch myself. I remember Ben Johnson up here. Ben was doing a conference in Montreal, and I set him up. I set him up real good. I got him some good speakers, lined them up with that, and we got them to come in. Lord said, make him pay for it. I said, Ben's got to pay. He said, you're not going to help him very much. I said, oh, Lord, Ben's going to be stretched now. And Ben, you took care of that whole conference by yourself, didn't you? You see, Lord, and he's one of my boys. Like, I'm so proud of Ben Johnson. Ben Johnson came down here when we did the conference with Charlie Robinson a couple years ago. And Ben got all fired up. At that point, he didn't really even have a ministry. But we went home after that and started prophesying in the streets. Gold dust began to break out in Montreal. And I think within months, he started his ministry called We Are One. And he's ministered all over Quebec now. And had hundreds of people come to his conferences. That conference, he decided, was going to be a two-town conference. And had people shuttling us between towns to preach revival in two campuses. Are you hearing me? And it was all taken care of by God, because God told me not to help him. Are you hearing me? Stretch the boy. Woo! Oh, listen, you just got to know God is God. He owns the cattle on 1,000 hills. Some of you don't know that. Some of you are just like, if I just eat lunch today, I'll be happy. I don't have money for nothing. I can't even buy nothing. I'm like, you poor thing. I'm serious. You don't have a vision of how great your God is if you're worried about your daily bread. You don't have a vision of how great your God is until you begin to step out in the Word. I get myself in trouble all the time with my fellow itinerants. I'm going to get myself in trouble again tonight. They're like, you'll get these sometimes. Here's a list of all the things I need before I come. 3 plane tickets, 3 or 4 hotel rooms. I need a car. I need all this plus all this in advance. I'm going, and this is me. I'm just being honest with you now. And they get upset with me, and they're probably going to get upset with me again. I'm like, where's that in the Bible? Because my Bible says something like in Matthew 10, it says, don't worry about money for your money belt. But when you go, money will come to you. That's Matthew 10. And that's what I've been following, guys. I went to 16 nations last year. Some of those guys who do that, they're like, how did you do that? I said, well, somebody asked me to come, and I said, I'll go. They're like, how did you do it? I just believed that because they asked me to come, God was sending me there. Now, I don't go to every place, but what happens is I get a dream, and I'm a seer prophet. So I'll get a dream that some country is going to open up for me. Australia was that way. Europe was that way. Even British Columbia was that way. The United States was that way. The reason why I went to Texas the first time is I had a dream about 5 years ago, and I heard in the dream there's something the same about Texas as to where you were. Where I was in the Ottawa Valley in the middle of revival. And when I went to Texas, we started seeing wild revival break out. I've been back there 13 times in, I think, 3 or 4 years. I can't remember how long now. That's where the rain began to follow my ministry. I was in a meeting down there one time, and a spiritual raindrop fell in the room. It was like translucent blue and yellow hit the floor. And after that, thunderstorms started following my ministry. Crazy ones. I'm talking wild ones. I'm talking, you better hope that you're in God's will being here today kind of thunderstorms. I was just in Sydney, Australia, and the day I landed, 2 days later, they're going on the worst storm in 100 years. Is heading toward the east coast of Australia. I go, there's my life right there. Whew. It was like so big. And Australia is as long as the United States. Are you hearing me? Like the east coast is as long as Florida up to the north part. There was a storm that wrapped itself right around the east coast. But the worst part came in towards Sydney. And there were like 15-foot waves crashing on the shore, wiping out buildings along the beach in the city we were. And when we look, my son goes, Dad, look, there's a river coming down the road. The whole thing, and wind, bang, bang, bang. It was crazy. And that's normal. I don't know why, but I remember I was getting ready to go to Australia, and I was like looking at the temperatures. It's winter there right now. And I'm like, how cold is it going to be? It's not as cold as here. But it can get cold because I was there before. You kind of need a warmer coat because it's a wet cold, you know what I mean? And so the Lord said in a dream, take your rain jacket. I was like, oh, God, no. I got this bright yellow rain jacket. I mean, when it's on a guy my size, I look like a melon, you know what I mean? Honestly, I don't want to look like a giant banana down under, you know? I said, I ain't taking that rain jacket, God. That was a mistake right there. Because every place I went to in Australia, it rained. It rained for 2 months. I went to Adelaide, Australia, which is on the south part, which is the coldest part. And it rained so hard in one night. They had more rain that night than they did in 75 years. In one night. In Sydney, they had 600 millimeters of rain. Now, that would be the equivalent of 600 centimeters of snow in one fall. Are you hearing me? In one night. I was in Alice Springs, and rain came down. It was hail. It was hail. 4 days after we left, there was hail so strong, it filled up the streets, and there was flooding in the streets. The water was like ice going down the road in the desert. That was in the desert. The desert was filled with life. There was green everywhere in the desert when we went out in the desert because the rains came. I went to Perth, Australia, and a few days before I went there, there was an earthquake. Now they're getting disturbed by me coming, you know what I mean? They're like putting out, who is this guy? Whoo! And I didn't say to all of them, you need to give me $5,000 in advance. You need to pay my plane ticket. You need to pay this, that, and everything. You know, every town I went to had 3 or 4 people with me paying their own plane fare. Most of them ended up with money in their pockets by the time they left the town because they were following the same policy. It's in the Word of God. I think I got a little authority on the subject. Are you hearing me? I'm in the 16 nations in 1 year all over the earth. Are you hearing me? And I can tell you what, God's word works. When God says it in the Bible, it's as good as it as it's just like a policy. It's like a contract. It's right there, and you step into it and do it, it manifests. And that's my story. Now, I've told that in Canada in some churches, they get all angry with me. They get angry with me. They'll get angry with you if you talk the way I just did. And some of you in the room probably did too. But the floodlights are so good, I can't tell. Joe, you've been all over the place. Didn't have to worry about too much to do it, did you? God took care of you. God took care of you. But you got to have a vision. You got to know. You got to seek the Lord until you find him. Some people, they actually go on their own good ideas, and their good old ideas are not worth 20 cents. What you need is God's ideas for your life, and you'll get those as you seek him. And if you'll seek him, with all your heart, you will find him. Oh, here's a story. I didn't tell this one yet. If I was here 3 or 4 nights, I might tell the same story. I might have already. I don't know. So I'm in Australia last year. I was there twice, last year and this year. This year, 9 weeks. Last year, 10 or 12 days. When I was down there, an angel from Europe came to me. And he went like this, welcome to Europe. And so I didn't try to make that happen, but I've been to England a couple times, and I was planning a trip to England to preach in England, Wales and Northern England. And as I was planning that, a friend of mine from Quebec, who's a mutual friend of Ben and I, called. He said, Darren, I see you're going to England. You should pop over to Belgium as well. I thought, well, that's that old angel working that, you know. I thought, I'll go. I said, yeah. He said, he can't pay you much. I said, I'm not worried about that. And I got over there. But within 3 days, I had set up 5 countries. And I had a 21-day tour of Europe and preached in 5 nations. I preached in 2 nations in 1 day. But the day I landed in France, something happened in France. You know what day that was? That was November 13th, the day they shot down 113 people in the streets of Paris. Now, I was flying into Paris that day. And I thought, I actually got on the plane in Ottawa. I was flying to Detroit. And as I got aboard the plane, that's when it began to happen in Paris. And I landed in Detroit. A guy walked up to me and said, did you hear what happened in Paris? I said, no, I'm going there. What's happened? And he thought he had heard 60 people had died. And then my friends on Facebook knew I was going, so they started freaking out, you know. Are you there? Are you all right? I'm like, I'm all right. I'm all right. I was having a coffee at that point in Detroit at the airport. And they were going, you're not going now, are you? I said, yeah, huh? Whew. I had written Lydia just before that. I said, Lydia, I said, I know stuff is going on there, but I was born for this. She goes, I got peace about it. I said, I love you, honey. I'm coming home. You know that, right? Why? Because I've seen my future. Don't tell me I'm going down. I got a lot of life to live yet. I got a lot of ministry to do. So I got aboard that plane, and I flew into Paris. I slept in the airport with my hand on both my bags with guys with machine guns all around me. And then I got aboard trains and began to preach all through Belgium, up into Holland, flew into Germany and back to Paris. And where I was staying in Paris was really like it was like a new immigrant community, and I was preaching in house churches. And in one of the house churches that I went to, by the way, I'm preaching here today. I might be in a house church next week. I could be preaching in a church with 1,000 in it, not before too long. I don't make, you don't have to have me just for a big meeting, you know what I mean? I go where the door opens and where people are hungry. I had one of my mentors said to me, he said, Darren, always pray, Lord, send me to the tribe of the hungry. Yeah. Woo! And that's what I do. I just go wherever the door opens, and miracles, signs, and wonders happen. And so I'm in Paris, France. It's 4 days after. I was planning to go down to the spot where the nightclub was where they killed everybody. And I got on the train and got lost. Now, I ended up at the CN Tower, but it was actually the Eiffel Tower. That would have been a long train ride, you know, right there. And there was hardly anyone there because everybody was terrified. And I got out underneath that tower, and I said, Jesus Christ is still Lord. Yeah. And I know, listen, the revival in France, I've studied it. And all that trip, I just began to remind the people of France of their history in Christ and began to declare revival would break out. In every town I went to in France, we saw crazy signs and wonders. I was in a house church. Oh! Woo! I stayed in a bedroom where I had no privacy, because they would come in the room while I was lying in the bed to get whatever they wanted. So I slept with my clothes on the whole time I was there. I was, you know what I mean? But this is the truth. You don't make this stuff up. Whew. So I'm in there, I'm preaching, and we're in a house church. 40 people show up. I mean, everybody's like this, because it's a tiny 800-foot square apartment. Just a tiny thing, you know what I mean? But the whole glory of God came down in those meetings, and people were touched deeply by the power of God. And there was one lady in those meetings who was Islamic, but she's a Christian now because she had a dream and Jesus appeared to her. And now she sings in choirs all across France. But she was from the same nation as the terrorist that had just blown up the streets. Looked like one of the young ladies who was dating the head terrorist, who cried out in her apartment as she was shot down, "That is not my boyfriend." And then she started opening up fire at the police, and they took her out. That occurred in the same day I was in this apartment. It was 9 blocks away. Are you hearing me? We're preaching Christ in the middle of a war zone, and there's no life like it. You want to go on a venture? Just trust God. You want to see things in an amazing way. Listen, I love conferences. I like the green room with the chocolate covered almonds. I'll eat them all day long. Give me the Perrier. Are you hearing me? But listen. The greatest miracles I've seen are not in places like this. The greatest miracles I've seen are where people are very needy. And I hate to tell you, you guys aren't very needy. You think you are. You're more interested in dialogue. Shh. Some of you think you know it all. You're wooing and awing and doing this and everything else, and manifesting this way and that way, but you ain't doing nothing for the gospel. That's tough old Daddy Darren coming out right now. Some of you in this room really need an encounter with God and not making them up and entering into the place of belief. There was a man who I was mentored by, and he didn't even know it, 10 years ago. His name was Todd Bentley. Todd Bentley, I used to soak all night long to his CDs. Whoo! I had the CD. It was an MP3. There were 12 albums on it, and two of Todd's were on there. Bob Jones, Prophet Bob Jones, was on that CD. And he would talk about the Billion Soul Harvest, and then Todd would come on and talk about stuff. Stacy Campbell, come on. In the middle of the night, every time Bob Jones, his voice came out, I would go, "The Billion Soul Harvest? I'll be doing that." I was like, listen, whew, in one day this year, one of my updates got shared on the Elijah list, and it hit 250,000 computer screens in one bleep. And I said to myself, what a wonderful life. No, I said to myself, God, that ain't nothing. There's so many more souls. There's so many more people. And we get caught up that there's 100 in our meeting, or 200 in our meeting, or 300, or that there's 1,000 watching, and there's 7 billion souls in this earth, and about 5 billion of them at least are going to hell. And we're worried about 2,000 or 3,000 people on our computers. That's complacency. God has strategies and methodologies for us to reach the globe. Listen, I'm just a preacher man. I don't have many big meetings, but I tell you what, a lot of places break open in the spirit when I go there, and a lot of revivals break out after I leave. I always tell people, I'm like a wind, like a flame. My only job is to go in and release the bomb so that other people can come in and release the glory. Breaker anointing, a lot of the times, comes with a little tiny bit of glory, not much. Because I'll go into a region and there's only 20 people in there and they're all filled with religion and lies. They'll be like, nothing good can happen in this town. This country, no revival can occur here. I'll just go, lies! They're like, what? What are you talking about? Look at me. I'm a fire. I'm a flame. Let me tell you what God wants to do through your life. 20 people in a room. Next thing you know, boom, revival breaks out. These people are going wild in the streets. I was in one place. Remember, Ben and I went down to Virginia. I got published on Elijah List, and three ladies showed up in a house church in Virginia, and they said, Darren, would you come down to our town? I said, oh, yeah, I'll come down to your town. They said, we got this ministry. It meets in a furniture store. I went, a furniture store? I said, yep. Would you still come? I said, I'll come to your furniture store if you want me to come. And they were hungry. Gold dust broke out all over their faces, their hands. These guys were wild, and they were all enjoying it. You know, some people get messed up. They don't like it at all, but these people were wild. Are you hearing me? I went down to their furniture store. Somebody just got upset about that. Good Lord. Thank you, God. I went to their furniture store, and all of a sudden the miracles broke out. I was there an hour and a half at the most, 2 hours. Because it was a small group. The smaller the group, the better, because I'm going to prophesy over anybody anyway. So if there's only 20, that's a good night. You know what I mean? So, and when you're on the road like I am, you're in a different town every night, it adds up after a while. Most trips, I'm prophesying over 1,000 people on a trip. Whew. So I get into that town. The people get covered in gold, and then they think, I can do that. And they began to walk the streets and release gold in the streets. Walked into really religious churches, and all of a sudden the churches, people in the churches were getting gold dust all over them. They were messed up. And then they thought, I said, well, I'm going to come back to that town, and I'm bringing Ben with me and Wesley Campbell. And they got all excited. So we went down there with Wesley. They thought, well, we could get Wesley and Darren in this town. We're renting the biggest room in town because revival is going to break out in this town. So they got the local auditorium that could hold 800 people. And then they began to prayer walk it, go in there and cleanse it. You know what I mean? The kind of wild intercessors like you all in this room. Whew! And there was a guy in there in a wheelchair. And they go, that guy don't need to be in that wheelchair. And that's what they thought. There's no reason for that guy to be in that wheelchair. So they pulled him out, and he began to walk. And I had only been in that town an hour and a half. Just before I went there, this is what they said. We didn't even want you to come because they got beat up so bad about 2 weeks before I went there by the religious folks in town. We were shutting it down. And the only reason why we had you is because we felt obligated. And then they became, they're still going. They've had people drive 2-3 hours into their furniture store and got deliverance there. All the time that happens. I had a woman recently. I'm a prophetic artist as well. I got all kinds of art with me on this trip, but I haven't brought it into the room. But I do. I have about 14 paintings with me. I keep forgetting to bring them. Whew. So one of those ladies bought one of my paintings. She came out of a real religious church. She didn't believe she could dream or have visions. She got that painting, put it in her house, started having 3D visions, and started remembering dreams she had before in a little town where they dared believe for revival. God began to move by his spirit, and the book of Acts began to manifest in their midst. Now, I was going to New Zealand last year. And I decided, I mapped out my route. I thought, I'm going to Hawaii, baby, in between. You know what I mean? I'm only going to get a 10-hour layover, but 10 hours in Honolulu, that's better than 10 hours in Vancouver. You know what I mean? Now, I like Vancouver, but You know what I'm talking about, right? So I had a friend who was in Honolulu, used to work with Joe and Hunter, and now he was down there doing ministry. And I wrote him, I said, dude, I'm coming through. Let's have lunch. And he wrote back, I'm giving you the number of another person. You have lunch with them. I thought, dude, that's so rude. She writes me, she says, I can set up two meetings for you in the 10 hours you're in Honolulu. I said, well, let's do it. She said, it's in a donut shop. Well, my God, I could probably use a donut on the way through. We got into the donut shop, and all of a sudden the Holy Spirit came down, and I'm prophesying. About 40 people showed up in a donut shop, and that was a big donut shop, not like, you know, some of the small ones around here. But the lady who owned the shop got touched so powerfully by the Lord, she went out and bought me fruit. The lady goes, you don't understand, that woman wouldn't buy nothing for anyone. And she buying you fruit? She must have got touched by God. And then we started prophesying, gold dust started breaking out in the donut shop. All of a sudden, a woman came in off the street, a little tiny Asian lady. She was probably like that tall. And as soon as she came into the door, one of the wild ones grabbed her. Come here. And she's like, come up to the front. She goes, I don't know. What am I doing? She's like, who are you people? Who are you people? I've never been in a room like this before. And all of a sudden, I started prophesying over her. The gold dust started breaking out all over her. And she got touched powerfully by God. Now, if I had to say I needed a bunch of money up front for that, it probably wouldn't happen. You can trust God's word. See, God, you know, Todd Bentley, you know, I was talking about that. He preached a sermon that hit me so hard that I can never forget it as long as I live. It was called The Go of the Gospel. If you want to see miracles, signs, and wonders, you got to go. You got to stretch yourself beyond where you are. See, some of you, all you want is a miracle in your own life. Some of you just want to get healed. You just want to bless me gospel. You just want the latest, the latest touch or the latest fragrance, or you just want the latest revelation, but you don't want to do anything for the gospel. But if you really, and you're in this room, want to see God do something, you're going to have to go outside your door. You might have to go across the street. Eventually, God might send you around the world. And you can't worry about, listen, before long, this trip we went on, I brought my whole family. We had, I think I told you last night, had to raise $10,000 for that. Came in 3 weeks flat because I saw it in the dream. I knew God wanted me to go. But before I could believe for $10,000, I had to believe for gas to go to Kinburn, which was a 45-minute drive from my house where revival was going on. And I didn't know where the money was going to go. They put in the tank for the way home. I'm telling you the truth. Ben did this recently. Ben, we were just out in Ottawa. Ben borrowed his mom's car. I think the muffler is hanging off. And he was the chauffeur for the whole week. And he was driving around all the speakers. And his gas was on empty and she didn't run out. He only had a little bit of money to get to Ottawa, and he said God wanted them there and that his hunger would fill the gas tank. I like those kind of people. And it did. Got him all the way to Hamilton. God will fill your gas tank, but you got to be hungry. Your hunger for God has to be greater than your hunger for gas. So you hear me? A lot of people say, oh, I'd love to go to that meeting, but I couldn't afford the gas. I think I never let that stop me. I remember I'd get out to the church and inevitably somebody would walk up to me and I'd get what we used to call back, because I'm like Pentecostal roots, okay? Some of you got to forgive me for that, but that's what I grew up in, right? I'm talking the old school Pentecostal now, and the ones that got angry. That's what I grew up in, and that's why I ran away from the church for a long time. But when I grew up, they used to talk about the Pentecostal handshakes. I don't know if you know what a Pentecostal handshake is. some person in the church would walk up. There'd be a $20 bill or a $50 bill in the hand, and they'd say, "God bless you, brother." And then you'd get the, you're like, "Ooh, that felt like money." You ever get that? You know, and that would happen week after week after week. Somebody would give me money. At one time, I went to the gas station, and me and my mom went there. I got to the gas tank. There was a guy from the church on the other side of the pump. He said, "Can I fill your gas tank for you tonight?" I said, "Absolutely. Thank you, Jesus." And that's how I learned to walk in faith. I just began to believe for gas. I had nothing, and God, for the last 12 years, has provided everything. I've learned to trust Him with all my resources. I want somebody tonight, we're going to sow a seed here in a bit. I'm telling you, I mean, I'm sowing all the time. I'm not just saying that. I do that because it's broken open my ministry in ways you cannot even imagine. I remember one time I was in a Bill Prankard meeting in Ottawa. And I remember I said, "God, I want $1,000 to actually buy camping equipment because I wanted to go camping." And I remember I got a new credit card. Now, you might think I'm crazy, but this is the way I did it. I got into the meeting. I had $1,000 room on that credit card. And somebody sitting at me said, "If you sow $1,000 tonight, God is saying," and he did. That's what they said. "If you sow $1,000 tonight, God is going to break open your ministry. You've been fighting it. There's been a blockage. But if you sow tonight, God's going to break it open." And I hit my heart. That word was for me. I was like, "But my camping gear? I wanted," you know, I'm just being honest. Look, guys, I did it with credit card. I'm telling you the truth. I'm not telling you to do that. I'm telling you what I did. I sowed that thing. Within 3 weeks or 4 weeks, I was preaching in 6 churches. The money got paid off. Every time there's a blockage in my ministry, I sow radically. I just sow crazy seeds because I'm not going to let a blockage stop me from entering into the place that God has ordained for my life. I can trust God with my increase. Are you hearing me? I can trust Him. I can trust Him to let me have a vacation too now. I can trust Him to take care of my house, take care of my children, their teeth. And all that by faith. But you got to enter into it by faith. And, you know, I want you to tonight, and some of you even in some of this word is even for people out there in cyber world, social media world. Some of you are out there listening because you didn't feel like you could afford to come. And I want that lie to be broken over your life. See, I'm coming against, in the spirit, every lie that says you can't. Scott there, I don't think you had the money, but you just did a 5-week trip throughout the United States, went to every revival that broke out in the last 6 months, and to some of the revival pools in the southern part of the U.S. How many kilometers was that? 20,000? 20,000 kilometers he drove. That's called hunger. Now, let me tell you about Scott. I know Scott. Scott's one of the most radical sowers that I know, him and his wife. I don't know who gives more, but they both give a lot. And that, as a result, God has used them mightily. Are you hearing me? And He'll use you mightily. Some of you in this room tonight can sow. And these guys need your money. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm not taking any money from these meetings at all. You know why? I got a new season I'm about to enter into, and I'm going to do it radically. There's a shift coming in my ministry. I just had a prophetic word in a dream. You hearing me? Listen, this is what happened. Now, Jesus, you remember, went up onto the mount, brought Peter and the boys with him, the Mount of Transfiguration. Remember? He went up there. Who appeared to him? Elijah and Moses. And they came to strengthen him for the hour ahead. Now, I believe that still happens. I believe those people in the great cloud of witnesses still come, and they still prophesy, and they still encourage us. So, the other night, the Apostle Paul came to me in a dream. Now, I think some of you are probably like, "Woo-hoo!" And then there's some other people who are like, "Oh, thank God he said that out loud, because I've had similar experiences myself." He came to me in a dream, and he just stood on the table. He looked straight at me, pointed his finger in my face. He said, 20 cities are about to open up for you, and there will be rest or houses in each of those cities. I thought, that's my word. That's from heaven right there. I'm sowing radically to enter into the shift. And since then, I've been sowing radical seeds. And so one of the radical seeds that I'm doing for this is all the money that comes in for me for this weekend, I'm giving back to Joe Garcia so he can fly and see his 80-year-old mom who's lying in a home and not doing very well. Are you hearing me? I want him to see his mama at least one more time. So my money is going to that. And that's not because I got money. Are you hearing me? That's because I got faith that I'm doing that. You're hearing me now. I live day by day. If I go back home, tell Lydia, I said, Lydia, you know what? I didn't take any offering for that. She go, what? I said, honey, it's time for us to live by faith. I love you, and you know it. She'll be right good about that. She's put up with me for a long time. I told my wife, you leave me, I'm going with you. I said, honey, I said, you're stuck. You're stuck. You leave me, I'm coming with you, girl. Whew! But she and I have learned to live by faith, and my wife is wilder in sowing than I am. We have everything we possess because of what I'm talking out loud. And there's two things I want you to sow into tonight. Joe's mom getting Joe to there. He's going to need at least $1,000, if not $1,200, to get to see his mama. And I want you to sow into that. And then I want you to sow. They're going to need some new equipment because the cameras are. They need some new equipment. They need a new computer to continue the social media ministry. Todd is moving on, as you know, and he's taking his stuff with him because he needs it. And he's going to be traveling around. He's going to be broadcasting. But this ministry is continuing on. And they need some more equipment. And I would estimate between $5,000 and $10,000 is what they need for that. And some of you in the room can do that. Listen, a $5,000 seed to you might seem crazy for most people in the room. But listen, there's somebody in this room. Because listen, I've been in that spot where I did it and sowed that kind of money. There's somebody in here can do it. There's somebody in here can sow $500. There's somebody in this room can sow $100 is a huge seed for you. There are people in this room, $10 is a huge seed for you. And I want you to do that. See, you want to get into the next season. Are you hearing me? You just want to, listen, you put God on the test. God, I'm going to trust you for increase. Now, I'm doing that knowing that you're taking a risk. But you look, I'm a risk taker. I just bought another new car today for my ministry. And I didn't go cheap at all. I don't know where that money is going to come from. But I had a dream. Are you hearing me? I sold my car about 2 months, 3 months ago. I called it my government car. The one that I used to drive to work in the government. All government cars, they're gray and black, you know. Four-door sedans, and that's what I had. When that car, I didn't need it anymore because that old season is gone. So I sold that car. It was worth about $3,500 to $4,000. I sold it, and then I had a dream. You want to hear the dream? That's why I got the car I did today. That car turned from what it was into a Dodge Challenger, all souped up with a good motor. Guess what Daddy bought today? I got my Challenger. I got it. I got it today. Why? Because God said I could have it. Now, some of you got all upset because I said Dodge Challenger. Some of you don't even know what it is. But let's just say a muscle car. Are you hearing me? Two-door muscle car, and it's got all the bells and whistles, but I'm just believing that God's going to use that car to touch people's lives. You might think that's strange, but I understand social media a lot better than you do. I understand the way it works, and I understand the people out there want to see people who are blessed. Even if the church doesn't. The one of the words that God had from Bob Jones. Now, as you're doing that, I want you to pass those envelopes out, but I can tell you this story. Bob Jones, before he died, had a vision. Or actually, one of his boys had a vision. He saw Bob Jones, and Bob Jones came to him, and he gave him a candy bar that said 67 on it, and they knew that that meant Psalm 67. And Psalm 67, if you read it, is about the blessing coming upon the people of God to make the nations jealous. God wants in this season, and I think you probably have heard other people say it before, before the big revival breaks, the blessing of God is going to manifest on the people of God, and it's actually seeing that blessing upon your life. Seeing the offspring blessed, seeing the children spread, seeing your house blessed, seeing your life is blessed. They will be jealous for your God, because our God owns the cattle on 1,000 hills. Some of you thought I should just go out and get a tiny little two-door smart car. That ain't going to happen. I'm going to tell you what. God knows that God can take care of that. I just have entered into a different realm and understand him in a different way. But you can too. And as you sow tonight, again, I'm not taking anything from this tonight. I want you to know that you're sowing into this move of God. You're sowing into the Garcias. He's worked hard in the last 3 months, and I want him to see his mama. So as you do that, sow a seed into that. And I'm going to tell you what, God's going to break stuff open in your life. Your prodigals are going to come back. Are you hearing me? Your family is going to be touched by the power of God. Your house is going to be blessed. And if you're out in the Facebook Live world, in the social media world, and you're tuned in, you can go to, I think it's the River International, riverchurch.ca. On it, there's a button called donate. It's a blue box. You can go there and you can make a donation online. And I tell you what, God's going to bless you. He's my God. I love that God. He's a good guy. He's a good, good father. He blesses me like you wouldn't believe. I'm so blessed, it's ridiculous. I'm going to tell you the truth. I look at my kids, I look in their eyes, and I see Jesus in their hearts, and I go, thank you, Lord. Are you hearing me? I said, my son the other day as I'm leaving, I said, boy, I'm going to miss you. He said, Dad, I got to be honest with you. How long are you going for? I said, I'm going to be gone 3 days. He said, well, I tell you what, Dad, I may or may not miss you. I may or may not miss you this time. And then we laughed. But I tell you what, I love my family with all my heart. I do, and I bless them like you wouldn't believe. I always take them out, and we bless them. And that's what you should be doing, too. And I don't do that because we got lots of money. I do that because I'm a good father, and you're good, too. I declare the blessing's going to manifest on your life. So with that said, just pass out the things, the buckets. There's a hole in the there may not be a hole in that bucket. Whew. And before you leave tonight, I'm going to prophesy over those that were not here last night. And if you didn't think you're coming to get a second word, I apologize, but I'm conserving my energy. I love you, though. But I'm going to prophesy over the people that were not here last night. And if you want another prophetic word, you can type Ben, and Ben will type them all out. I'm teasing. Ben, I'm going to get you to go over there. Or you can go over by Ben. I don't know how to do this, Joe. Get Ben just to go to, like, the line, like, for me and for Ben. Okay, Ben will be over on this side. I tell you what, Ben is better at prophecy than I am. I'm not just saying that, guys. Ben is incredible, crazy. He'll tell you things about yourself. I prefer him to my prophetic ministry because he's one of, listen, you got to raise each other up, right? He's a powerful prophet, and he's on his own right. So I'm going to release him. He's going to give you word, and it's going to mess you up for good. Amen? And he's preaching tomorrow morning, right? Yep, right here tomorrow morning. You don't want to miss what this young man's got in his heart, because he's already a father in Canada. He's a father in Quebec. He's seen revival break out. You don't want to miss the word that he has tomorrow morning. 10 a.m., and we'll have fun. Amen? So did we get the buckets through? Okay, can we get a little, I always say kumbaya, a little music or you want to? Oh, you want to come up and do that? Yeah.
Glory to God. As the buckets are going around and as you're sowing, we just, so whoever needs, whoever was here last night, that's the word, right? Goes with Ben on this side. Whoever was not here last night needs a word from there and goes on. What's that? And we thank you for watching and tuning in on live stream. If you are watching this broadcast by replay, you can send us your prayer requests at prayer@theriverinu.com. We bless you. We declare increase over your lives in Jesus' name. The prayer lines are open, and we just declare the blessing of the Lord over your lives in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. So you can hit music if the live feed is off. If there's a big line here and you want a word, then Ben is the man. Glory to God.